Hello guys, good morning. This is our third class. In the previous class, we had discussed what is program, how to write program, and definition of program, instructions, all basic things we had discussed in the previous class. And also, we had run this program using developer C++. If you have not yet downloaded the developer C++ IDE, please download it and practice these programs. They are very helpful while doing the project. Okay, let me recall what we had discussed in the previous class. This is an IDE, Developer C++. IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment. It has editor, linker, debugger, and other essential utilities required for running the program. Okay, so the first statement, which begins with ash, is called preprocessor statement. It is used to include the predefined functions present in the standard header file. The reason for writing this in this program is to make use of printf statement. Okay, fine. And main is a function. I had told that function is a place where we arrange our instruction, and main is an user defined function because it is defined by us. Printf is also a function, but it is defined by someone else, and hence we should call it as a library function. And here we have used printf to display statement on screen. So this is what we had discussed in our previous class. Now, let us understand variables. So, in simple, variables are nothing but memory locations of RAM. They are used to store data. Here, data means a data may be a number like 10, 20. We call them as integers. Or data may be a fractional numbers like 2.2, 3.134, etc. These variables are called floats. And there may be numbers with the high accuracy. That is, after decimal point, they may need, you know, a more accurate value. Such variables are called doubles. And if you use the things like alphabets or digits or special characters, these are called characters. Simple. In C, we have these four basic data types, that is integers, all whole numbers, float, fractional numbers, double, fractional numbers with 16 digits accuracy after decimal point, and characters. These are the basic data types available in C. So the conclusion is very simple. Variables are memory locations of RAM. They are used to store data. Why we need to store data? If you want to perform any operation on data, it must be stored in a variable. Then only we can perform operations on data. So simple, memory locations of RAM are called variables. They are used to store data. Why we need to store data? To perform operations on them. What operations? Maybe arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, or logical operations like comparison, equals to, greater than, less than, such things. So this is what the purpose of variables. So let us understand this concept by writing a simple program to find the sum of two numbers 10 and 20. So the one more rule is, when you need variables, they must be declared before being used in the program. How to declare? Data type followed by variable name. Variable name can be anything like num1, num2, sum. I have taken three variables, num1, num2, sum. All three are of type integer. Fine. After declaring the variables, we can assign any value. I have assigned 10 to number1. Similarly, let me assign 20 to num2 and then perform operations on them. Sum is equal to num1 plus num2. Let us try to display the result. How to do that? We have printf statement. Let me display using /n. Result equals, and one more thing is, whenever you want to display the content of a variable, you need to use format string. I want to display the sum. Sum is of type integer, and for integers we have format string %d. Okay, so let me clear the reason for using %d. I want to display content of a variable, that's why I have used %d. Here we have three variables. You need to tell which variable you want to display. We will do that by writing like this, comma separated by the variable name, that is sum. let us terminate with semicolon. Fine. So what it does, it displays result is equal to is a string. Result is equal to is a string. It will be displayed as it is. And in place of percentage D, the content of variable get displayed. Here percentage D is technically called format string, and D stands for decimal integer. The value, the variable sum is having value 30, and in the output screen we get to see 30 being displayed. Let us check it out. Compile the program, run the program. Yes, hope you can see result is equal to 30. So we did a simple arithmetic operations on variables. Fine. Similarly, we can perform subtraction, division, multiplication. No problem. We can do that. And let us try one more thing. Here I have initialized num1 with 10 and num2 with 20. So instead of initializing, can we read the data from keyboard? Yes, we can do that. How? For that purpose, we have a function called scanf. Printf, it is meant for displaying, that is output operation. Similarly, we have function called scanf to read the data from keyboard. I will show you how to do that. Before that, let me explain the syntax of scanf to you guys. Okay, so the function name is scanf. Let me increase the size so that it is visible to you. Hope you can see scanf. In scanf, you need to mention two things. The first thing is, you have to mention the format string of variables. Format string of variables you have to mention. And then the second thing is, you need to mention address of variables. What is address? No problem. Whenever you declare a variable, it gets allocated in memory called RAM. When it gets space in RAM, it will be having a unique number in the RAM, and it is technically called address. So to get the address, we have operator called ampersand. By writing on ampersand after variable name, we can fetch its address. So let me show you practically. A is a variable in of type integer. How to read A from keyboard? The first is format string. A is integer, so you have to mention percentage D as its format string, and then you have to give address of variable. That's why we write ampersand A. By writing like this, you can read an integer value to variable A. Similarly, if you want to read a value to float variable, the syntax goes like this: percentage f ampersand b, because percentage f is the format string of floats. Similarly, if you want to read values to double, you have to mention like this: ampersand d. Simple. Even we can read values to two variables, writing like this: ampersand a, ampersand b. Simple. So this is the simple syntax. So let us try in our program. So I will write scanf percentage d, percentage d. Since we are reading two variables, I have written percentage d two times. First percentage d for number one and second one for num two. Then let us mention address of variable number one and then address of variable num two. Simple. Okay, see, please recall the definition of program. What was the definition? A program is group of instructions. See, in main function, we have these many instructions for the purpose of finding the sum of two variables. So let me execute this. Yeah, the screen is blank. The reason is the scanf got executed. If you input 45 followed by 78, we should get the sum of 45 and 78. Yes, the result is 123. Hope you did notice what happens when I execute the program. The first instruction is scanf. So this is the instruction which gets executed first. So yeah, it is blank. So the user will not be aware of why it has come to screen. That's why the common practice we follow is before scanf, we write printf, which will indicate the purpose. Enter two numbers. When user reads this statement, he will come to know I have to input two values. That's why it is a common practice of writing printf before scanf so that user will not get confused. Yeah, now it is clear. Enter two numbers. When you input two numbers, yes, the result is 30. This is how we did a simple addition program using printf and scanf. Let me recall once again: variables, memory locations of RAM, used to store data, reason for storing data, to perform operations like this. Okay, and using scanf, we did read values from the keyboard. What is scanf? It is a standard input function. And what is printf? Standard output function. After performing addition operation, we displayed the result. While displaying, we used a format string. The reason for using format string is to display content of a variable. This is a very simple C program. So let us compare these things with IoT. Here, scanf, we are inputting values through keyboard. That's why we have used scanf. When it comes to IoT projects, there we have sensors. Sensors acts as input devices. Okay, so sensors are input devices. When these sensors are connected to input-output pins of development board. Therefore, how we write value is equal to digital read pin number 33. What does it mean? You are reading a data from the sensor which is connected to pin number 33 of our development board, and the read value is stored in a variable called value. Why digital read? We will come to know those things later, no problem. And even we write like this, analog read, pin number 32. So this is how we do in IoT related things. There we don't have scanf. Instead of scanf, we use digital read, analog read. Such functions we have. Just to understand how things works, I have written this simple program. Later we shall convert it to IoT related things. Okay, no problem. Hope you did understand this simple program. That is, enter two numbers, reading two numbers, finding their sum and displaying the result. Now, let us change this program to biggest of two numbers. Instead of writing sum is equal to num1 plus num2, let me try to display which is big. Okay. All the things remain same. Reading data from the keyboard and everything is same. Here, I need to compare the two variables, that is num1 and num2. How to compare the variables? For comparison, we have relational operators. In C, we have relational operators. What are relational operators? How they look like? So, equals to is one relational operator with which we can compare two variables. Greater than is one relational operator with which we can compare whether among two variables which is big. Similarly, we have less than, greater than or equals to, less than or equals to, and not equals to. So these are the relational operators available in C with which we can compare two variables. So to solve this problem, I need to use any one of the relational operator. My aim is to find the biggest. That's why I will write like this. If num1 is greater than num2. So what it does? This expression is called logical expression. The reason? The output of this expression is either true or false. That's why any expression which is formed using relational operators is called logical expression. The end result of this expression is either 1, which represents true, or 0, which represents the false. After writing logical expression, we need to use control statements because they select the statements for execution. So logical expressions alone won't help us to get our task done. For example, I will show you. If I write only this, num1 greater than num2. So if this condition is true, I have to display num1 is big. Okay, if this condition is false, I have to display num2 is big. Yeah, I have written both the statements. Now my program has to select this statement if above condition is true, and it has to select this statement if this condition happens to be false. We need one more facility which helps us to select statements based on outcome of this expression. How to do that? We have if else statement. If else, it is technically known as control statement. Why it is called control statement? It controls the statement to be executed based on the condition. That's why it is called a control statement. Let me show how to use this. Just you write if here. If this condition is true, select this one. If this condition is false, select this one. That's why this is called if block. The place which comes immediately after if is called true block. The space which comes after else is called false block. Sometimes we write flower bracket too. When you have only one statement, you need not to write the flower bracket. Simply you can use no issues. When there is a more than one statement, you have to write flower bracket. I will show you both the cases. Yeah. Okay. Let me check how it works. Let me execute this program, compile and run. I should get entered two numbers. Yes, enter two numbers. I will give 12 followed by 45. Num2 is big. Yes, because 45 is big. I will give 200 followed by 45. Num1 is big. Yes, it is perfect. It is working. Yeah. So what did we understood from this program? We have control statements. And to use control statements, having logical expression is must. What are logical expressions? Expressions which are formed using relational operators is called logical expression because it returns either true or false. This if else, which takes help of logical expressions and helps us to select the statements for execution. So this is how we can write a simple C program to find the biggest of two numbers. These if else, variables, all these things are very useful while doing IoT applications. So please you practice the programs, these simple programs, download, that developer C++ IDE. If you unable to download, let me know. I will share the link so that you can install it and practice these programs. Please you practice these two programs. Again, in the next video, I will explain how to write nested if, else if ladder, all those things. Hope you did understand. If you have any queries, you can post in our WhatsApp group. I will clear your doubts. Thank you.